15.4 litres later, 173 miles. No idea. It's got to be around the 50. A full fuel gauge. And also where the fuel is cold, it makes your legs cold as well, which is quite nice on a hot day. I can see the point of putting a tank cover on in the winter to keep you warm, but keep you warmer. But usually you've got thick padded linings in, so it doesn't really matter, to be honest, in the winter. This is a bumpy bit of road as well. Oh, I can get through it, can't I? Bit of dual carriageway coming up. Now there's a discussion. Convertible cars driving around on a day like today with a roof up. What's that all about? I mean, I've got a convertible car, and whenever I go out, it's not raining and the temperature's not too bad, the roof comes down. But I see so many people, especially in the summer, hot days, driving around, windows down, roof up. What's that all about? Why would you do that? Maybe the roof's packed up, I don't know. Now there's one with the roof down, good on ya. Nice bit of dual carriageway. On the left, not far from Peterborough now. Jesus. Well, I'm doing 70 and he's past me like I'm standing still. So he's not hanging about. Good luck. traffic looks tailed back along here as well. So we'll see what we can do here. See if I can get through or someone's going to block me. Oh. Now this is where you get the problems of people. U-turns. Yeah. U-turn, U-turn, U-turns. So you've got to be careful of this. This is where they take you out. I think we've got a problem down here. The road might be shut. Lots of people turning. We could have a problem. We'll take it easy and we'll see what's going on. Gotta be so careful. I've got a feeling the road's blocked. There's people in the road. It's looking more and more like it's blocked. Looks blocked. Oh dear. I think what I'm going to do is turn round. I do know another way. got to watch out for any U-turners. It's a terrible bit of road. You do get a lot of problems down here, especially if people are overtaking, something's coming the other way. Right, what we'll do, we've got to the next roundabout, we'll do a left. Do the first left, it will take us along the road just over there. Everyone else is doing it. I'm not sure if you can make it out yet, but there's a massive great bridge up here. It's this sort of greeny bluey structure. See it? We'll be going over it, but rather crazy really, the size of this bridge for what it's actually for. There was there's a small river that runs underneath. But for some unknown reason, they built this bloody great bridge. Not really sure why, but the thing is, before this road opened, the road started to subside, and it was shut for about a year, and so they delayed the opening. Because of the subsidence, all down to the fact they built this stupid bloody bridge. I mean, they built the ground up here. And you'll see as we go over it, pretty pointless. It's not as if there's a great big ravine or anything. There's just this piddly bit of water. Very strange, never mind. Maybe there's a good reason for it. If you know, stick it in some comments. Stick it in the comments. This is the A16 from Peterborough that goes to Spalding. So yeah, if you know anything about it, pop up a comment, let me know. Because what do I know? Nothing. Bit of a way round, but we got there in the end. There's a convertible with the roof up. Idiot. Got there in the end.